From the beginning, I decided that I wasn't going to retain any rights to this system except the right of nobody should diddle with it. If anybody could use my system free of charge, as long as they didn't make any changes whatsoever, it had to be entirely compatible with the system that I had, and I wanted to, so I didn't want to charge for anything. If this had been the only thing I had worked on in my life, I would have probably had, I would certainly have had a different idea. But I had seen the way proprietary things had been holding back the printing industry for years and years. There were five or six different commercial systems for describing pages of text, and everybody thought they were the system that everybody in the world would use, and they were totally incompatible with each other, and you couldn't use different fonts with different systems. It was all a mess. So I was thinking in the early days of computer programming languages, IBM did not keep Fortran as something that was an IBM-only language. They allowed dozens of other manufacturers to make their own Fortran versions, and that was a big boon to use of computers. I could see that the same would happen in the printing industry if I didn't retain proprietary rights to the use of this system. And I also made all my code available so people could read it and see what I had done and find mistakes for it. And I paid people if they found an error. So thousands of volunteers sprung up all over the world helping me get this system better.
Is this when you invented Weave and Tangle?
So the literate programming idea, the Weave and Tangle, came about shortly afterwards, 1982. First of all, I had written my program in a Stanford-only language. It's called SAIL, Stanford Artificial Intelligence Language. It's something that not many people could do, but in order to run at first on other machines, it was difficult unless they happened to have a PDP-10 computer, which is with a SAIL compiler. So in the early days, that's why MIT was one of the first users, and there were quite a few installations of this computer and system, but not. But it wasn't on very many different machines. So I don't think IBM mainframe you could run it. So then a student transcribed my code. This was Inyaki Sabala. Transcribed my code into Pascal. I think David Fuchs and Art Samuel also worked with him on this. Anyway, lots of people were working on this. I didn't do it myself, but they transcribed my program from the SAIL language into Pascal language, and then that would run on every computer. And that's where we had hundreds of different users, and then we started having annual meetings of the people from around the world to trade information.